Hello my dear children, welcome back to the SST classroom. Now in the last video we were discussing about the India 6th physical division. Am I right? As you all know, India is the largest, 7th largest country, right? And India is a country which have the different landforms that we discussed, that is the northern mountain, northern plains, desert, southern plateau, coastal line and island region. These all are the 6 physical division. Am I right? So what we have discussed about the all these six physical division, that we will do the recap. After that we start our new topic. Okay, so let's recap the 6 physical division. I hope you have understood all these 6 physical division. Now let's start the first. What we have discussed about the northern mountain, where it is located? It is located to the north part of India. Am I right? And here the Mount Everest is the, as I talk, there are many peaks, right? So the Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. That also we have discussed. Now my dear children, one more point. Now through this northern mountain, the glaciers are formed. You know what is glaciers? Means at some places ice slope down from the mountain. See in the picture here the mountain. Now from this mountain, the ice which slope down from the mountain, that is known as glacier. So that is formed in the Himalayas. Am I right? And then later we discuss about the second physical division, that is the northern plains. As I talk about the northern plain, that this plain is very fertile, because here the many rivers are flow in this northern plain. So because of that, this river make this plain make very fertile. And I talk in the fertile land, and it is very easy to grow crop. Am I right? Now because of this many rivers and its tributary, it form a basin. Hope till here you have understood about the northern plain. So what I talk about the basin, now as I said, here the many rivers flow in the northern plain. So what is basin? Area which is watered by river and its tributaries. You know what is tributaries? A small river which join the main river. Now take example here, the Ganga river. Ganga is the main river. So all the small river like Kosi, Son and other river which join this main river, it make its tributaries. So the I am talking about here about the basin, that area which is watered by river and its tributary form a large basin. Now after that we discuss about the third physical division, that is the Indian desert. So can you tell me where it is located, in which part of India? It is located to the northwestern part of India, and this desert is also known as Great Indian Desert or Thar Desert. Am I right? And here we talk about the climate. It remain hot and dry throughout the year. And here you will see very sparse vegetation. Means here the plants or trees is grow very less over here because of the what is the reason behind that? As this desert is receive very less rainfall, because of that you will see the trees are not found in this desert region. Only the bushes and thorny shrubs are found. Later we discuss about the desert is share the boundary between India and Pakistan. Hope till here you have understood about the physical division. Now see the fourth division, what we have learned in that, that is the southern plateau. As you know, the plateau is a flat surface area, and southern plateau is located to the southern part of our country, that is the southern part. It occupy the largest part of our country, and in that also we discuss the southern plateau. It divides into two, that is the central highland and Deccan Plateau. Then next we discuss about the coastline. So what we discuss about the coastline? There are India has the largest coastline, right? western coastline, and on the eastern side, that is the eastern coastline. And these two coastline are separated by Deccan Plateau, right? Then later we discuss about the island region. So what is island? A land, the land which is surrounded by water, that is known as island. So in that we discuss about the two island, Andaman and Nicobar, and the next is Lakshadweep. So Andaman and Nicobar, where it's situated? It is situated in the Bay of Bengal. And the second island, that is the Lakshadweep, it's situated near the Arabian Sea. Hope till here you have understood. About the sixth physical division. So today we will start the next topic of the third chapter, that is the India's neighbor. So you know what is the meaning of neighbor? The person which is next to you, or the house which is next to you, you tell as your neighbor. So in this we will see that who are our neighbors, which countries are our neighbors. As India, as a subcontinent, is surrounded by countries which is known as our neighbors. So we'll see which countries is our neighbors. Now if we talk about the land boundaries, India shares its land boundaries between the seven countries. So which are the seven countries? First we'll see the seven countries, that is Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal, China, Bhutan, Bangladesh, and Myanmar. These all the seven countries with India share its land boundaries. So first we will see that Pakistan and Afghanistan, it is in the west. In the west, it shares its land boundary. You can see the map. You know this is the map of India. So here you will see Pakistan and Afghanistan, it share the land boundaries in the west. The next we'll see in the north, that is the Nepal and China, it share its land boundary in the north. If we'll talk about the east, that is Bhutan, Bangladesh and Myanmar, it share its land boundary in the east. Hope till here you have understood about the land boundaries. Now we'll talk about the sea neighboring countries. So which are the sea neighboring countries? You can see in the south here, the two island, that is Sri Lanka, that is our neighbor, sea neighboring country, and other is Maldives, and this share sea neighboring countries of our India. Hope till here you have understood about the land boundaries. Now we will discuss, as India has a many religion. You know what is religion? A people, they believe in the different God, right? And India is also one of the most ancient civilization which give birth to four main religion. You can see a picture which four main religion give birth to the world. That is Jainism, Sikhism, Hinduism and Buddhism. Understood? So, my dear children, I hope you have understood the concept of India's neighbor and six physical division. In the next video, we will learn the new concept, that is political division. Now, what you have to do? You have to read the textbook and you have to understand all the concept. Okay? Thank you.